Johnny Rock Show. Rockin' 101, the Rock Station.
If it makes you happier.
Rockin' 101, please don't swear you're on the air. Is this Sheryl Crow?
Hi.
Hi, Sheryl Crow. How are you?
I'm very good. Is this Johnny Rock?
This is Johnny Rock. Oh, how are you? Well, I'm going to reintroduce myself. We've met a few times. You did Edge Fest for me back in the day. You did, a country show for me in Buffalo, New York at that baseball stadium.
Wow.
Yeah, you were there with Adarius.
Oh, my goodness. Right. Yes, I remember.
Yeah, I loved your jacket. Oh, you had this leather jacket.
Now that I don't remember.
Oh, okay. Well, I remember the performance. It was fabulous. Fabulous, I say.
Oh, good. All right. Right on.
Yeah. Well, hello again, as Neil Diamond once sang. Now, we're excited about this new documentary. There's docudramas, docuseries. Yeah. It's on Showtime. I'm going to let you talk about it, but I think from what I've seen, it's sort of a capsule of everything and more that Sheryl Crow has done. Do tell.
Well, it's actually, you know, it's an interesting thing to make a documentary when you have over 30 years. And there's a ton of story there, but we wanted it to be more about the person as opposed to like a recap of awards and performances and that kind of thing. So, It gave me the opportunity to kind of tell my story and about what all I've gone through, from being a woman in the music business to having breast cancer to, getting older in this business. There's a world of experience there that I think a lot of people will relate to that they won't have known just by knowing the song All I Want to Do.
Yeah. I'm listening to what you're saying and thinking about when you said all I want to do, because to this day I have friends that's really all they, with all due respect, that's all they really know from Sheryl Crow. And then I have friends that know every song, can sing every lyric to everything you've ever done. So it's interesting. But
it's interesting. I did an interview recently with someone who said everything that I thought I knew about Sheryl Crow was completely changed after seeing this 90-minute documentary. And that makes me feel good, because I think sometimes people forget that there's a person behind a song, and that song you may like or you may not like, but it's generally the story of the person that makes, that can change your mind about someone's music, for better or for worse, obviously. But it's been a great thing to be able to talk about, not only just being a woman in a business that's run by men, but to be able to talk about having, some real bouts of depression and understanding how to navigate that and adopting kids. And I mean, it's a pretty full story, and the director was fantastic. So, I hope people will like it.
Oh, it's going to be great. It's on Showtime, Sheryl. And then you have the soundtrack, music from the feature documentary.
Yeah.
There's a
lot of music in it that is part of the backstory, as well as music that everyone will know, of course. And then there are three new songs, one of which is the first song I ever sang with the Rolling Stones, which is in the documentary, Live With Me. And I actually texted Mick while we were doing it and said, hey, any chance you would play harmonica? And he's like, yeah, send it on and I'll do it. And I was, there he is, Mick Jagger. Kind of amazing.
Yeah, you still get a thrill from that you can text Mick Jagger?
Oh, my gosh, yes. Yeah, I mean, you don't ever stop being that kid that, that bought the records, that read the album notes, and suddenly it's like, oh, my gosh, Mick Jagger is playing on my record. And it's still a total thrill.
Oh, I can imagine. I on the Facebook page, I posted a few photos of you with Mick and Keith and Sorry for Your Loss, Charlie Watts. That must have been great.
Yeah. I've had a really incredible run from being, embraced by them at an early stage in my career. It's not anything I would have expected to ever happen, and it's it's been really an incredible run to be able to say that those guys have not only been very supportive of me, but they're also very good friends and love them, miss Charlie. Yeah.
Wow. Now, when we get off the phone, I still have a few minutes with you. We're going to give away a pair of tickets. Not yet, everybody. But we'll give away a pair of tickets July 5th at the brand new Ledge Amphitheater here in Waite Park. You're live and you're back on the road. Everything okay there?
Yeah. We're excited. You know, we've been doing a bunch of stuff since late summer with Chris Stapleton, and we're getting ready to go back out on our own. And man, it's just nice to play. I mean, it's just so good to get out and see people and to see people together and to feel that energy. So, yeah, we're excited about it. Yeah, we're ready.
And it's a beautiful, when I say new, I mean last summer was the opening, and they barely, you know, with COVID, they had like, I don't know, 5-6 shows the whole summer. So it's brand spanking new, July 5th.
Oh, that's killer. Well, we can't wait to get there.
Yeah. Now, people may not know, but I know the first time I ever saw Sheryl Crow in concert, you were with Michael Jackson on the Bad Tour.
Oh, wow. Yeah. You go way back.
Oh, yes. Well, you know, love them, hate them, whatever, say what you will. The Bad Tour with Sheryl Crow and Michael Jackson. Still one of the greatest concerts of my life. And I've seen them all, but that was...
Oh.
I mean, do you look back on that and just go, wow, I was so, you know... I was new to the business.
Oh, yeah. I mean, you know, like you said, love him or hate him. You know, he was undeniably one of the biggest artists of my time. And probably will remain one of the biggest artists of all time. If you can separate what we... you know, have sort of witnessed through the documentaries in the last few years. If you can, you know, put that in the back of your mind and listen to his early stuff before he was grown. I mean, he was fantastic. And to see the world being a singer with him, you know, it definitely transformed me, for sure. It was quite a gift.
Yeah. You and him doing, what was it? I Just Can't Stop Loving You. Every night.
I Just Can't Stop Loving You.
Oh,
yeah.
Crazy. I know you got to go, but along those same lines, I posted a photo of you and Minnesota's own Prince. I didn't know you guys were that type. Yeah. That's crazy.
Yeah, we were. And he recorded Every Day is a Winding Road, which was very cool and big honor. Came there, hung out with him, went to First Avenue, sat in with the band with him, and he was by far the most talented person I've ever been around.
Man, that's saying something. Wow. Well,
yeah, he was quite an amazing musician.
Well, you too. Let me tell you, it's been every day is a winding. Every day is a winding road with Sheryl Crow. July 5th, Ledge Amphitheater, in the Showtime, the documentary, the soundtrack. You got it going on. I mean, it's unbelievable. Every time I turn around, you got something new. That's great. Well, listen, I'll be there July 5th.
Well, I'm really blessed. And I will say that May 6th, when it comes out, I'm going to be walking around May 7th, knowing people have seen the whole story. And it's going to feel weird, but I'm excited about it. So go check it out, people.
Oh, and it's good. Okay, we'll see you July 5th. Sheryl Crow, honestly, thanks for, you don't do a lot of these all the time, so it's nice. Thank you for coming on the Johnny Rock Show, and we will see you this summer, okay?
Awesome. Thanks for having me on, Johnny.
Thank you. There she goes. Wow. Matt, see? I always say I said it yesterday with Jennifer Wilde, the bigger the star, not always, but usually the bigger the star, the smaller the ego, because they're jaded. They don't have time to be this thing. They just want to talk about their music or their projects and get on with it, you know? Now, July 5th at the Ledge Amphitheater. Sheryl Crow will be performing absolutely live. She'll probably do this absolutely live. we have a pair of tickets here. Three. Let's see here. What should we take? Let's say caller 11. Okay, caller 11, 320-252-6201. We'll give away these tickets to Sheryl Crow. Like I say, we don't play them, but we talk to them. Well, right now I'm playing them. And by the way, she can still sing. For real. A change! Because a change would do you good. There's a joke about Depends in there somewhere. Oh, I love this next line. All right. Morgs is coming in next. I've got to go get a winner for the Sheryl Crow tickets here. Thank you again. And tomorrow on the show, a Marky Mark live, like I said, from Las Vegas to the NFL draft. Oh, bring it home, Sheryl. Here we go. Thank you again to Sheryl Crow. Can you get me Alanis Morissette? I'll stay on the air till 11 if you can get me a lead singer of a garbage.
The Johnny Rock Show. Rockin' 101. The Rock.